What's up, y'all? Y'all are now in tune with Justin the G-Twin, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to let y'all pick my brain a little bit. It's going to be some times where I do some videos like this where y'all going to be able to see a few of those long, long verses that have a big message up in it or a moral up in it. And you know, I know everybody has situations like this where it's those shoulda, coulda, woulda. You know what? I'm not even gonna keep on talking to y'all and just like, you know, filling up your brain with words and talking. I'm just gonna go ahead and just get into it, if y'all don't mind. Some realities are hard for me to deal with. It just hit me when I started being real with myself, when I dealt other women in my past, the cold shoulder thinking that it really wouldn't last. Now my mask was my swag and beautiful white smile, with ambition to get into this musical lifestyle. I assumed that they really couldn't handle it. After dinners I meticulously candle it. Now my assumptions were really hypocritical enough, ever since that convinced me I really couldn't trust any woman that would say that she's in love with me. Well, all these other women up in every club I beat would be the ones that would draw me. All these gold diggers who wouldn't do anything for me. Surely I'm going on the road. Really, I don't know. I think I'ma be a bachelorette 40. Seeing just how many broken hearts that I contributed to. Categorizing myself with other men they've given into. It's something about the things that I say that isn't the truth that drives away the only woman I wasn't willing to lose. She was willing to do anything for me to just prove that I'm the man that she wants. But when I pick up my phone, I see a 2-page text and send back a 2-letter word, as if she was never worth what I should have been giving her. And I hear these single women saying, man, or not nothing. They look my way and say, nah, not Justin, cause he's the sweetest guy. But really, I think it's why it's so easy to be surprised in these evil, deceitful lies. Where we lay up on them when I say I want them, but I'm thinking, what a day I want them. The temptation is just a great opponent. What am I doing vacating where other players going and leaving my bae in the place where she has to stay alone in? But then it's probably the person that I am, right? I'm diagnosing the cancer I know I can't fight, knowing I continue to look for another chance like it's something that I couldn't control. I'm such a man, right? When I reflect in every heart that I ripped into pieces. Now my new thesis is that the cause and effect of a woman becoming bitter, demanding all the respect, knowing karma depressed, that broken heart in the chest is me. It's just the burden I carry, but what is scary, cause no emotion can flow to precipitate any tears. Only thing that will flow is the blood that comes from my brain that would fill up my lower body to temporarily feel that lust that I confused with love. But then I didn't mention nothing when I knew what's up. So me admitting I needed an intervention is really the biggest step to stop this woman's voice from repeating is when I'm thinking, well, I stupid, can I be really high, crazy in mind? And the reason why I struggle to look you straight in your eyes, cause every day that you cry, I know that you ain't wanna see our relationship die. I feel a crazy divide. Is there a way to decide that we should go our separate ways and just say that we tried and just cater a lie? Instead of saying it's my disrespectful, neglectful tendency, single-handedly draining and taking all of your energy now. I didn't notice it then, but no borders of friends should be doing you bogus over and over again. I know it has been more than what anyone should endure, but still you wore a smile like it was nothing to cure. Is just mind-boggling how you manage the bottle and every triggered emotion over and over, when I've been the biggest antagonist to your feelings. After an argument I started, I would ask you if I could have a kiss. I wonder what I would do if I was up in your shoes. What would I say, and then how would I tolerate if the bitter, terrible taste of you lying up in my face, it disgraced me. It's crazy I'm seeing all of my ways. So then when I reflect upon every heart that I ripped into pieces, now my new thesis is that the cause and effect of a woman becoming bitter, demanding all the respect, knowing karma depressed, that broken heart in the chest is me. It's just a burden I carry, but what is scary is no emotion can flow to precipitate any tears. Only thing that will flow is the blood that comes from my brain that will fill in my lower body to temporarily feel that lust that I confused with love. But then I didn't mention nothing when I knew what's up. So me admitting I needed an intervention is really the biggest step to stop this woman's words and repeating this in my head like, is it over? That's usually what will end up coming up when you hear like them texts and stuff like that. It'd be like, is it over? I guess you ain't gonna be mine no more, no more. Is it over? And you hear that either up in your head like, is it over? Or through the text messages like, is it over? That note was bad. But you get the gist of it. And I guess I'm gonna be giving y'all like certain videos like this. Sorry, y'all, I had to get into a serious moment. Certain videos like this, sort of, I guess, giving everybody something that they can be able to find an identity with. And not all of them are gonna be remixes. You're gonna have quite a few of them that are gonna be originals. But you know what? better yet said, or better yet done, it's going to be coming to y'all. It's been a pleasure as always.